Morning. From the Gospel according to Matthew, chapter 2, verse 10. Hear the word of God. When they saw the star, they were overjoyed.
Long ago, in a forest, there was three beautiful and handsome fir trees. These three fir trees hoped that someday they would be Christmas trees. They were very patient, and each day they grew and grew. Okay, truth be told, not very patient. They really wanted to be beautiful Christmas trees. They wanted to be a part of a family, to share in the joy of Christmas, to be the best Christmas tree ever. Living things, these trees did not grow equally. However, they did become great friends and talked a lot about what they wanted to be when they grew up. The trees wanted, they waited excitedly for a family to come and pick them up for the Christmas tree.
Tree growing tall, someday I'll be the best of all.
the trees, since they were kept waiting, were a little more reserved now. You see, it takes many years for a tree to grow, big and strong, enough to hold all the Christmas decorations. It takes many years for a family to come and pick them up for their Christmas tree. The trees were solid in their friendship and encouraged each other. They did notice that there was one tree that was a little smaller than the rest, but since they were such good friends, it didn't matter. Trees were very tired of waiting to grow up. It was so hard to see so many other trees in the forest go home with wonderful, loving families to be their Christmas tree. And then, one day, it happened. A family came to the forest and took a real interest in the three trees. Looked at all the trees and decided that this one would be their tree, their best Christmas tree ever. They took the tree home that very day and placed their most beautiful and prized decorations on it. The trees were very excited for their friend. He had achieved the dream that they had all shared and was now a part of a family. Came to the forest and they looked at all the trees. They didn't want a great big tree and they didn't want a small tree. They saw the tree that was just right.
Christmas tree.
that they found the perfect tree for their house, they took the tree home and placed it in the prized viewing of their living room and decorated it and loved it as their best Christmas tree ever. Phyllis's Christmas tree was very happy for her friends, but then she realized that she was alone, and she was sad and lonely. Wanted was to be a beautiful decorated tree and bring joy to a loving family, and she was sad that it didn't look like her dream would come true. While she was feeling bad, some beautiful red birds came and sat beside her little fir tree. They brought some of their feathers and string from their nest. They decorated the little tree with the feathers and the string. Began to feel better. Her friends will do that for you, you know. Soon, some little bunnies hopped over to the little tree. They brought some berries that they had found on the way. They strung the berries on the tree. String and berries looked so pretty on the little tree that she began to feel like a Christmas tree. She was just missing one thing. It was starting to get dark, and the stars were coming out into the night sky. Okay. stars knew that Christmas night was the birth of a special baby, and they had a big job to do. The stars were going to tell the shepherds about the baby Jesus lying in a manger. The one that was to guide the shepherds to the very special place where a family was going to have the very first Christmas. This tree held the star that guided the shepherds and all of us to the Holy Family, to baby Jesus, who came to earth so that all of us would be a part of the same family. The star looked just beautiful on the little tree, who is now the littlest Christmas tree, and she felt that she was the best Christmas tree ever. Don't you think so?
Beautiful tree ever, wasn't it? I know sometimes we get disappointed if God doesn't use us the way that we thought. We had a plan, we have a mission, we have a goal set out. And yet, we learn from the littlest and most beautiful Christmas tree that God will use us, maybe in completely unexpected ways, and will decorate us in a way that shows our beauty to the whole world. And so I thank you all for what you have shared with all of us today as we continue to prepare for Christmas and for the time that that star will shine and show us the way. So thank you all very much. If you would all stand and join hands across the aisles. Thanks. Oh, wait, I got it. Oh, Leslie just got outed. Oh, the little cell phone that could. Breaking through the silence. Oh, my. It is super important. Oh, wait. Bill's gonna fix it. So, as a reminder, please turn your cell phones off during worship. Leslie, Judy will have words to share with you of condolence later. Yeah. We have an opportunity to go from here and either despair and focus on the darkness, or we can go out these doors and we can know that no matter our circumstances, no matter if we feel like we're the smallest, no matter if we feel like we're the most insignificant, the one thing that we have is the light of Christ in our hearts. And that is the thing that we get to share with others. That is the thing that God adorns us with so that we might share the story of faith out into that world. That is what we must do to break through the darkness. Friends, continue the journey walking in love. Make peace and seek justice. God, go with great dreams in your heart. Live boldly, celebrate, and sing. Amen.